Hi everyone, this is Praveen here. So this is rectal region and this is the anal region. Friends, today we are going to discuss about the Houston's walls. That is John Houston, who was born in 1802 and we lost him on 1845. So who invented these walls? Friends, so this is a cross section of the rectum having different transverse walls or horizontal folds. Those are called as Houston's walls. So 1, 2 and 3, these are the classically present and is present in the most of the cases. Sometimes there may be a presence of the another wall also, and sometimes there may be presence of only two walls. So usually these are three in number, but it may vary between 2 to 4. The right-sided protrusion, this is the right-sided protrusion, is the largest and the most constant protrusion. So this is the largest and most constant protrusion. The left wall lies 1 inch above, 1 inch above and 1 inch below. So these are the left two walls. Usually fecal material do not occupy the space below the middle, walls, unless and until there is history of the constipation. And some books says the entire rectum remain empty in the normal healthy individuals, and some books says so this is the landmark where this space remains empty in the most of the cases. So dear friends, John Houston has published his paper in the year of 1830. He has published a description of the prominent mucosal folds that characterize the lumen of the rectum. He had a cerebral hemorrhage while giving the lecture to the students, and we lost him in the year of 1845. So when we look into the other references which are available nearly about 5000 years back, so as this is, I usually refer the book that Shushruta Samhita, which is written or edited by the professor G.D. Singhal sir. In the chapter number 2 of Nidanasthana. So what is Nidanasthana and all is, if the time permits, I will explain in another video. Okay, what he says, it is written in Sanskrit, which is told nearly about 5000 years back. So tatra stula antra, stula means large, antra means intestine. Tatra stula antra, stula antra pratibaddha ardha panchamangulah. So what he says, at the distal part of the large intestine, it is 4.5 angula. Angula we can say this much, or else the breadth of the one finger. That is the measurement they used to tell in the olden days. This is called as one angula. The breadth of the finger is called as one angula, or else we can take a distal part of the phalanx, that is one angula. So approximately we can take it as 1 inch. So what he says, tatra stula antra pratibaddha ardha panchamangula means 4.5, that is distal 4.5 inches approximately we can take. That part is called as gudamahu, that part is called as the rectum. Tasmin valayasmin, so there are, he called, these are the valayas, that we call it as the walls. So valayas mean, so I'll directly come into the point. So which is having valayas mean, so adyardha angula, adyardha angula means 1.5 inch, 1.5 angula अदर्द अंगुलः संभूताः, देन ही नेम इट एज प्रवाहिनी विसर्जिनी संहरणी चेति चतुरांगुलातात्। सो दीज आर द वलयास, ही नेम्ड इट एज प्रवाहिनी विसर्जिनी एंड संहरणी। सो देर आर थ्री वॉल्स इन द रेक्टम, दोज आर नेम्ड एज प्रवाहिनी विसर्जिनी संहरणी चेति चतुरांगुलायतः। सो दीज आर हैविंग द ब्रेड्थ ऑफ फोर अंगुला। सो आई कम इन टू हियर, व्हाट द सुश्रुता सेज अबाउट 5000 ईयर बैक इन द रेक्टम, सो डिस्टल पार्ट ऑफ द बृहद आंत्र, दैट इज स्थूल आंत्र, ही सेज स्थूल मीन्स लार्ज, आंत्र मीन्स इंटेस्टाइन, सो द डिस्टल पार्ट ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन विच इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 4.5 इंच, द डिस्टल पार्ट ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन इज कॉल्ड एज गुद, सो दिस पार्ट इज कॉल्ड एज गुद, एंड एट द ईच 1.5 इंचेस देर आर थ्री वलयास आर देर, सो एंड ही नेम्ड इट एज प्रवाहिनी विसर्जिनी एंड संहरणी। सो ही टोल्ड दीज आर द थ्री वलयास एंड द ब्रेथ ऑफ दीज वलयास इज फोर अंगुला, 4.5 अंगुला इज द गुदा, 4 angula is the breadth, and each walls having a distance of 1.5 angula. So, and he says, these are having the shape of Gaja Talu. Gaja means elephant, Talu means pellet. As the pellet of the elephant looks, in the same way, these are having the shape. Then why he called it as Pravahini, Visarjini, Samharani? What is the meaning of that? So probably, so he named after their appearance. Pravahini means something like flowing, like a river kind of thing. Visarjini means one which is immersed, and Samharani having the similar color, so similarity to the adjacent structures. Though this could be a probable meaning of that, these words are in Sanskrit. Sanskrit is one of the oldest language in the universe. So when we call these walls as are the John Houston's walls, because he published a paper in the year of 1830. So if it is so, just because of that reason we are addressing these walls as a Houston's walls, then Sushruta is the person who has mentioned in his classics about 5000 years back. So probably this will become injustice towards the Sushruta if we call it as the only Houston's walls. So, as per my opinion, we should call it as Sushruta and John Houston's walls. Sushruta has named it, and John Houston has published it and recorded it. So, this is all about the Houston's walls. If you find this is a worth value spending time in my channel, then kindly subscribe to the channel and forward the videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching my videos.